One police force alone had issued 123 penalty notices, while another six required people to attend the magistrate's court for coronavirus-related offending.
Yeah, love to be sentenced by a judge on Skype. Also, Greater Manchester Police have broken up a bunch of house parties, which I admit, like, this is one thing where the enforcement is correct, is that people should not be having a fucking house party. But, like...
You can't stop Manx.
Yeah, the tweet, never trust cops with Twitter, because what they put out was... This weekend, Greater Manchester Police attended 660 parties. It's like, okay, maybe you shouldn't have done that then.
Well, they finally opened the evidence locker and took all those pingers.
Oh, no, just you. That's a lot of face touching. Mm. No bueno.
I feel so also connected to everyone.
Do you see like what some of like the kind of like right wing contingents of like Twitter and like Facebook are kind of talking about when it comes to this? It's really interesting.
Oh, yeah.
It's really interesting because like as we talk about just like the kind of trigger happy policing that this country seems to love and like the consent that so many people give the police, their take wasn't like, oh, this might be like a bit of too much over policing and like this is a concern of civil liberties.
I'd have sent in fucking Land Rovers, wouldn't I? And like clouds of tear gas.
It was a mix of that, but it was also like, oh, these police have so much time to arrest old pensioners in the supermarket, but they don't have enough time to investigate the grooming gangs.
Interesting.
What about the firearms in the mosque? So I just find it just very funny that like, even during this fucking pandemic, there are still like a sizable number of people who are both like either stuck on the grift or like they're fighting old wars. It's kind of like, you know, it's kind of, again, like that contingent of people that despite this fucking pandemic are still, going to like FBP people and being like, oh, we won, Brexit's done, etc. Like the kind of like last Japanese fighter on the island.
Yeah.
And I don't know. I have like a begrudging respect for them.
Their whole county's dentists.
Yeah. What you've got to understand is that in this country, there are two genders of your dad's attitude to the police, which is gender the first. Please arrest my neighbor for buying a Twix and behead him. And then gender number two is I got a speeding fine from a new speed camera because I was doing 40 and a 30 in my Vectra VXR. And this is me being burnt at the stake for the crime of being English and owning a performance vehicle.
But that's a big difference between like a British aggrieved dads and American aggrieved uncles. Because American aggrieved uncles just love hierarchy. And like, no matter what the police are doing, they'll sort of work their way around to whatever it is.
Those guys get like 20 DUIs, and the whole time they're licking boot, and they're like, "Yes, sir, thank you, sir."
They weren't even drunk; they were just like, "Can I have another DUI?"
That guy who did the tweet this week that was like, "I was once beaten bloody by the police, and I said thank you for your service."
Yeah, whereas in Britain,
I mean, I've been there.
In Britain, we are much like you got to. I hate to say you gotta hand it to them, but hey, at least they're consistent in their principles. It's just that their principles are garbage. But here's the thing. This has all been building up to two announcements that police... Wait, I can't remember which of you guys said that police forces should not be allowed near Twitter. Two police forces that have both been patrolling grocery stores.
I love this is such a strong mental image for me, and I want us to put it on a poster or on a t-shirt or something. I love that when I am like moving between spotlights of the like roving police drones, I am given away and I'm instantly compromised to a permanent end by a SWAT team because of the blare of unexpected item in the bagging area.
Yeah, absolutely. Just getting fucking turned into a red mist by a predator drone because I accidentally got oat milk.
Yeah.
The police putting my hoard of goo ramekins into evidence bags as I'm choked to death.
But yeah, so what they've said is they have said we will not at this stage be starting to marshal supermarkets and check the items in baskets and trolleys to see whether it is a legitimate necessary item. But if people do not heed the warnings, we will start to do that. Cambridge police also said they were patrolling the, quote, non-essential aisles in grocery stores.
The siren call of the non-essential aisle drawing me in.
What you've got to do is you've got to pass like a speech check to speak cop to them and be like, I have tactically ascertained this Twix style nourishment in order to like replenish my carbohydrates.
So, Josie,
I want to throw involved eating of a Twix.
Yeah.
So, Josie, I want to throw to you on this. Have you purchased any non-essential food items?
Yeah.
You do not have to answer that. As your lawyer.
I have never bought more dime bars in my life. But the thing is, obviously, we're only going to a shop once a week to pick up our local organic fruit and veg delivery that we participate in because it's a community scheme. Deal with it. And we go...
You're a perfect liberal elite right here.
Yeah. I made a joke on Twitter today saying that I may obviously never become a permanent member of the middle class and, you know, may never ever be allowed to stop renting or feel as if I have any security in this world. But I got an email from Ocado today saying that I was on their priority shoppers list. So, you know, things are looking up for me. But basically, I go to the shops once a week and get like things that I need for my baby and fruit and vegetables. Of course I'm going to buy 1,000 fucking dime bars. Otherwise, what will I eat while I'm looking at Stacey Solomon's Instagram stories?
Just putting my head in my hands in the interview room.
Well, also, here's
the other thing, right? I don't regret
a
dime bar. If they weren't essential, why would they sell them in IKEA?
Well, here's the other thing, right? This is a slightly serious point, which is... This is the broad discretionary powers given to police forces to just decide what to do and decide what's essential and decide to even like say that to have massively overinterpreted this enough to say that we get to make sure you only do the bare minimum to stay alive means that like, let's say, I don't know, you have a dairy intolerance and you buy oat milk. Well, like the Spectator and Spiked have been spending the last 12 years saying that like oat milk is a metropolitan indulgence. So I hope you like puking and farting because you buy oat milk, we're gonna beat you to death.
What if you're not white?
What if you're buying like spices or what if you're buying like I don't know like what
spices
if you're buying,
are illegal?
But literally, yeah, like what if you're buying spices? What if you're buying food that they don't consider like normal British food? You're like, oh, that's a bit weird. Can't be essential.
What is non-essential? And also, like, why, if we're looking at the hierarchy of needs, like, I have a daughter who's going to be 2 in a month. Is it non-essential for me to buy art and craft supplies? And is it non-essential for me to buy her toys? Because, like, those are the aisles that we're talking about in a supermarket. What else in a supermarket is non-essential? Like, if it's non-essential to buy things to occupy the mind of a 2-year-old, what the fuck am I supposed to fucking do?
Have you considered telling your 2-year-old to go pick vegetables?
Too busy clapping for Boris. I can't help her. Every 5 minutes she wants to leave the house and say, well done, Boris.
Because she's his illegitimate child.
So it's a complicated issue.
We've become...
Josie, did you just admit to shagging a Tory?
No, of course canceled. Fucking not.
We've become a different kind of tweet. We live now in the world of Richard Dawkins. We thought he was being ridiculous, but it was actually prophetic. We are now all having a tiny little jar of honey taken away from us by stupid rule-bound dundridges.
Oh, damn. We owe him an apology.
The police, obviously, this whole thing has been, like, winding me up for, like, weeks already because I've been, like, paying attention to the fucking shit the police have been saying. And when they say things like, we may have to take more action when people aren't heeding the warnings, it's like, there have been no warnings that said you can't go to the supermarket. Going to the, like, if there are lots of people in the supermarket, that means lots of people need food, which is something you're allowed to do. And given that the supermarkets are selling other things, which will, like, make your isolation more bearable, there is no reason not to buy those things. What the kind of fucking insane entrapment is it to station a policeman in the, like, quote-unquote non-essential aisle to, like, lure you in? It's just like the big, like, you know, getting a mentally impaired Muslim teenager and getting him to accept a big box with bomb written on it in crayon, and then being like, well, 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 it seems we've caught Osama bin Laden again.
Yeah. But like, I have a Russia angle for this, which is like, we talk a lot about how repressive and authoritarian Russia is in this country. And it's very funny to me that the only video I've seen of the like Russian coronavirus quarantine is a guy in a park in Moscow just sitting in a police van on the loudspeaker being like, you have to go home, go home, please go home. And people just like walking past and cycling past and just totally ignoring it.